Good evening. I am Alex Morin, the senior class president. Members of the class of 2020, proud parents and guardians, Superintendent Grady, Principal McDonald, Vice Principal Schutz, and Coach Jordan, our class advisor. I would like to welcome you all to the graduation of Mount Greylock's class of 2020. Today marks the destination of a successful four-year journey for our class. I hope you all remember throughout life, your travels should be about the journey you're on and not the destination. I understand it has been tough and difficult, especially in these trying times. We've been asked to forfeit so much in these past few months. Many will remember this as our defining moment in high school. Do not let this assumption hold true. In these few short months, we have found the true meaning of friendship. We have gathered together and supported one another. Graduation marks more than ending one chapter and starting another. It marks the beginning of when you and you alone make decisions that will affect the rest of your life. Some will be easy, others will be challenging. Be bold and take on new challenges. You have all worked hard to get here. But most importantly, congratulations. You have earned it. Thank you and welcome.
Welcome, class of 2020, faculty, staff, and families. I am honored to be here today to bring greetings and congratulations to such an inspired group of students. As I began thinking about what I should say to you, I discovered that I could go for hours talking about the class of 2020 and your diverse interests and accomplishments. Art show participations, vibrant musicians in school and in community orchestras, robotics, strong athletics, championship teams, strong academic performance, commitment to work-based learning, drama, especially Shakespeare and Company and the musical this year, student government, school newspaper, peer team, yearbook, club participations. This is just a quick reflection on who you are and what you have done. You should be so proud of yourselves and what you have accomplished. You did all of this with many obstacles in front of you with the physical aspects of a school building, so thank you. I also have been reflecting on life lessons to share with you. My husband reminded me late last evening about how speeches, such as the Greek philosopher Socrates, was killed by his friends for long, long speeches, and it would not be what you want to listen to today. So, since I'm no Socrates, nor do I want to end up like Socrates, I will be brief in my speech. Today, I want to take the time to say we are truly sorry for the senior experiences you have lost and had to do via remote participation because of COVID-19. I am confident that this class and the resiliency that you are made of, you will use this as a growing experience, an opportunity to help change the world from what you have learned about this pandemic. On Saturday morning, as you drive through for graduation, please know the parking lot will be filled with classmates and family members that are so proud of you. You all entered the world shortly after 9/11 and the fears we lived through during this time. You are exiting high school during a pandemic, which has forever changed the world as we knew it. If we all thought about what a successful graduate is, I'm pretty confident we would hear a theme of recurring words or phrases repeated: integrity, responsibility, perseverance, dependable, committed. You have all mastered the Greylock way. Congratulations, and continue to do great things in this world.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Nicole Overbaugh, and I would like to thank you all for tuning in. During this unprecedented time, I am honored to have been chosen by my fellow classmates for this address. We've truly lived through it all at Greylock. We entered 2014 eager-eyed, but with trepidation. Our first few days of school introduced us to lockers that wouldn't close, ill-temperature classrooms, and hallways slicked with sweat on humid summer days. We were also met with social changes. All of us needed to learn what deodorant was, as addressed in Ms. Moore Powers' classroom in the seventh grade multiple times. We all needed to gain time management, as many of us were still on elementary school level homework schedules. But most importantly, we desired to stand out in a class that had held a reputation of being standout before we even stepped onto Greylock territory. Now, as Mr. Thistle would say, I'm gonna go off on a wicked tangent, but if you'll bear with me, I promise this will link together in the end. My years at the school have truly allowed me to explore different pathways and interests. I believe one of my most enriching experiences at Greylock stemmed from my time on the yearbook committee. Since my freshman year, I've had the pleasure to document school functions, arts events, athletics, and the candid life of your average Mount Greylock student. Also, since my freshman year, I've been stockpiling these photos on multiple flash drives for no reason other than the fear of losing them. Mr. Powers, you have taught me well. Little did I know, in 4 years' time, the images I had stowed away would unlock many forgotten memories. In fact, I used several of those pictures to gain inspiration for this speech. As we drive off our beloved, newly renovated campus in 2020, I'm sure we are all eager-eyed, but with some trepidation. The future is uncertain, but as I flipped through my photos recently, I recognize just how much we've changed as individuals. I see how passionate we've grown into our personal abilities, interests, and talents, and just how we will be able to take that forward with us into our future endeavors. Max Ree's passion for music has launched him into his next steps at the Youth Center, offering guitar lessons to beginner-level players. Brooke's activism through the Yes Club has inspired many students to follow her path and make change in our community's environment. Julia Donati shares her love of theater with our school through her fantastic performances on and off the stage, and the several seniors involved in robotics have sent their team to statewide championships with their hard work and perseverance. The list goes on, but I mustn't forget to mention the growth we have had together. We've always had a positive reputation in our district, even before we came together in middle school. Many consider us the golden class. Now, I might be slightly biased, but I can see exactly why one would say that about us. We are the class that creates change, and we are the class that adapts to change. We've never cowered from change either. From small changes, like being the class that advocated for microwaves in the cafeteria, to large changes, such as voicing opinions on our new school and adjusting to construction work and construction noise. Even now, we are living through undoubtedly one of the biggest changes of our high school career. We have learned to adapt in both school and life to the challenges COVID-19 presents, while still being able to articulate our desires for the remainder of our education. Yet, despite all of the change, our class has never wavered. If anything, it's brought us closer together. My experience on the yearbook committee has allowed me to appreciate the complexity of a picture. The saying is true, a picture is worth a thousand words. With that in mind, I urge you, class of 2020, to capture the moment. A picture offers a gateway to our past lives and unlocks memories that otherwise would have been skimmed over. In our case here, pictures have the power to illustrate development and allow us to reflect on changes in and around our own lives. You may realize that we really did stink in seventh grade, and Ms. Moore Powers wasn't lying to us. You may realize that your time management has significantly improved, or if you're like me, has significantly deteriorated. But most importantly, I hope you all realize that we stand out together because we are the change. Thank you all for listening. Be well and stay safe.
Thank you. Good evening. It is an honor to be here speaking on behalf of the faculty to the class of 2020. Although the circumstances are not what any of us expected them to be, I'm still thrilled to be given the opportunity to help celebrate such an amazing group of people. Our 4 years of high school have been anything but ordinary. It all started the spring of our freshman year when the gym was blocked off as part of the upcoming building project. Going to school while another school is simultaneously being built on the same property could definitely be a little chaotic. One of the best parts of ninth grade physics was that you could see the gigantic mound of dirt outside from Mr. Louie and Dr. B's windows. Coach Gill's epic fitness days were forced to take place in a room that was previously used for cat dissection, and students could no longer experience the crisp, cool air of the cold corridor on their way to gym class. Regardless of the changes happening to the building, the community and the spirit remain the same on the inside. If you walk through the middle school hallway, you might be able to hear Mr. Blackman's fabled songs or cheers from Ms. Barrett's MCAS madness. Or you could walk down the science hallway and maybe catch a whiff of the burning matches in Mr. Burdick's chem labs. When the building was ready, a new kind of chaos ensued as we tried to settle into a new home while beginning a new school year. I think it goes without saying, though, that the situation we find ourselves in now is by far the most disruptive and unexpected thing to happen in our 4 years. All across the country, high school seniors are experiencing the same thing. No prom, no senior trip, no graduation, or at least not a traditional one. As a whole, the class of 2020 in America will be defined and remembered by the coronavirus pandemic. However, I believe that when I think back on my years of high school, I will not remember all the things we were sad about not being able to experience. Instead, I'll remember all the smiles, laughs, and people that made my experience as great as it was. I'll remember Brody encouraging everyone to get going every Tuesday at lunch. I'll remember Mr. Thistle and Mr. Welch's tandem loudspeaker announcements advertising both basketball games and the school musical. I'll remember the renowned Mount Greylock dodgeball tournament and every other event that gave the entire school community an opportunity to come together at the same time. Because the new school building was finished right in the middle of our 4 years, it's difficult to call either building a home for the class of 2020. At least it's hard to say that we had a physical home for our 4 years. Be that as it may, I once heard a saying that goes like this: home is not a place, it is a feeling. Now, though we may have been lacking a physical home, I always felt at home when I was spending time with my classmates. I felt at home when we went to Gettysburg as a class before high school even started. I felt at home in the stands watching my friends compete in the sports that they love. Most of all, I felt at home when we were all together in the bleachers for our senior pep rally this year. It was truly a privilege to run around in circles in the dark, throwing toilet paper at our peers with all of you. Leaving home is never an easy thing to do. It's scary having to move on from something that has felt so familiar for so long. But the best thing about a home is that when you leave one, you open the door to find another. Some of us will find a new home in college, some in the armed forces, and some in the workforce. As we all leave to find these new homes, I implore you to think often about the people who helped you get to where you are and thank them if you get the chance. One of the hardest parts about leaving home is saying goodbye. It's especially hard for us because we didn't really get a chance to say our proper goodbyes. Our last day of school was fittingly Friday the 13th of March. It started off with somebody jamming a bunch of forks and clementines down a toilet, forcing first floor classes to take place in the cafeteria, and it ended with the announcement that school would be closed for 2 weeks. I can say with certainty that it never occurred to me that when I walked out of school that day, I would never walk back in as a student again. I'm sure that's the case for many, if not all, of my classmates as well. So I will implore you once again to, whenever you get the chance, say a proper goodbye and thank you to whoever was important to you during your time in our home at Mount Greylock. However, I'll steal a phrase from one of my all-time favorite speakers, singers, and songwriters, Bob Thistle. Do not say goodbye. Say so long, as in let it not be so long until we see each other again. I look forward to getting a chance to say my proper so longs and thank yous to everyone that made my experience as memorable as it was. For now, though, as I wrap up this speech, I would like to say some broader thank yous to everyone in the school community. To all the administration and staff, thank you for all of the work that you do to ensure that our experience is as great as it can be. To all the teachers, thank you for your guidance, your humor, and probably most of all, your patience. You are the reason that this school perfectly cultivates an environment of fun while learning. Lastly, I would like to thank my classmates. There's sincerely nobody I would have rather gone through high school with. Every single day, getting to see you guys would make having to get up at 6:30 in the morning just a little bit more worth it. As we all step out into the world, I encourage you to appreciate every day, because we know better than anyone how quickly things can change. Keep working hard, keep pursuing your goals, keep laughing, find a new home, and don't forget this one. Thank you.
Welcome, family and friends. I'm Jake Schutz, assistant principal at Mount Greylock. I have the honor and privilege to present the Class of 2020 Graduation Ceremony Awards. The Mount Greylock English Award is presented to the student who has demonstrated a high degree of excellence in the study of English during their 4 years of high school. This year's Mount Greylock English Award is presented to two students, Madeline Zoe Art and Owen Alexander Tucker Smith. The Mount Greylock History Award is presented to that member of the senior class who has done the best work in the study of history. This year's Mount Greylock History Award is presented to Mitchell Peter Jesuit. The Alfred J. Leonardi Prize in Mathematics is presented to the graduating student with the best academic record in mathematics during their high school years. This year's Alfred J. Leonardi Prize in Mathematics is presented to Madeline Zoe Art. The John D. Gill Jr. Science Award is presented to the graduating student with the best academic record in science during their high school years. This year's John D. Gill Jr. Science Award is presented to Charlotte Elizabeth Rauscher. The Class of 1950 Foreign Language Prize is awarded to the student who has demonstrated the greatest overall accomplishment and proficiency in foreign language with at least 4 years of study. This award is presented to recognize the student's consistent efforts in the language program and to encourage a student's continued pursuit in the field of language, literature, and culture. This year's Class of 1950 Foreign Language Prize is presented to Taryn Shea Garrity. The Elizabeth S. Piper Memorial Latin Award is awarded to the member of the graduating class who has earned the highest scholastic average in the study of Latin, given in honor of Elizabeth S. Piper, former teacher at both Williamstown High School and Mount Greylock Regional School, who through her life exhibited a profound concern for the education of young people. She was a dedicated teacher and a loyal friend to the colleagues and students alike. This year's Elizabeth S. Piper Memorial Latin Award is presented to Madeline Zoe Art. The Clara Well Elpert Memorial Art Award is awarded to a member of the graduating class who has demonstrated unusual artistic talent, creativity, and promise in the field of art. This year's Clara Well Elpert Memorial Art Award is presented to Julia Marie Donati. The Mount Greylock Music Award is presented to a graduating senior who has demonstrated outstanding dedication and achievement in music throughout their high school career. This year's Mount Greylock Music Award is presented to Max Schutzman Ree. The Mount Greylock Business Technology Award is awarded to the member of the graduating class who has earned the highest scholastic average in business education courses taken throughout high school. This year's Mount Greylock Business Technology Award is presented to Samantha Marie Pierce. The Mount Greylock Wellness Award is presented to the graduating senior who has demonstrated interest and ability in a broad range of health and physical education issues. These students have shown the aptitude to put knowledge and skills acquired in the classroom into practice. This year's Mount Greylock Wellness Award is presented to two students, Brandy Grace Gill and Max Schutzman Ree. The John B. Clark Scholar Award. This award honors John B. Clark, Williamstown High School teacher and principal between 1922 and 1960, a man of sympathy, integrity, and ability who devoted his life to assisting young people to realize the best that was in them. This award is presented to students whose four-year record indicates outstanding promise of success in higher education. This year's John B. Clark Scholar Award is presented to five students: Madeline Zoe Art, Miriam Camille Bacchia, Charlotte Elizabeth Rauscher, Grace Lynn Sanchez, and Owen Alexander Tucker Smith. Congratulations, awardees. To the class of 2020, enjoy your next journey. Remember to work hard, have fun, and be safe. I wish you all joy and happiness.
Hey there, I'm Lucas, and I'm going to Brandeis.
I'm going to Oregon State.
Awesome.
Go Beavs.
Hey, it's Braden, and I'm going to UHeart next year.
I'm going to the most haunted college in America, Smith College.
Sienna Merch, but I'm actually going to MCLA! Fulia!
Good evening. We're the class officers of the class of 2020. Please welcome us in congratulating the Teacher of the Year and the Staff Member of the Year.
For this year's Staff Member of the Year, the class of 2020 has chosen a staff member who we feel is a friend and supporter to students and faculty alike. He's always available to give you a helping hand, whether it be before, after, or during school hours, and always does so with a smiling face. He not only brightened the school's floors, but also the school's atmosphere. This is not the first time that he's won this award, but that just goes to show you how hard he works each and every year. With appreciation, the class of 2020 has chosen Ryan Scrocky as the Staff Member of the Year.
Thanks, guys.
I hope you guys have a good summer and the rest of your life. Going to college or whatever you guys decide to do. I wish you the best of luck. Go class of 2020.
For this year's Teacher of the Year, the class of 2020 has chosen a teacher we feel is very deserving. Starting in ninth grade, it was very evident that she was there for her students. No matter the time of day, she always has her door open. Whether you need help with an essay or a personal dilemma, she's always available to give a hand. Her English class is filled with instruction and conversation. Although we didn't always get the grade we wanted, we always got the grade we deserved. Her dedication and attention shaped all of us to the successful students we are today. Her gentle personality, charisma, and joy have the power to put a smile on anyone's face. They say in education that relationships are possibly more important than rigor and relevance. In her class, we get all three. And that is why the class of 2020 has chosen Ms. Hula as our Teacher of the Year.
Thank you, Gabby, and thank you, class of 2020, not just for this honor, but for all of your talents and passion and dedication that you've brought to Mount Greylock during these past 6 years. You've experienced things that no other class will ever experience, the building of the new Mount Greylock and ending your high school career during a global pandemic. You're certainly going to be a class to go down in the history books. But most importantly, you all handled it with grace and maturity and class. And those are attributes that show your resilience. And moving forward, if you bring those out into the world with you, they will serve you really well. I'm hoping that you'll all remember to be kind and patient and determined. Those are all qualities that I've seen in all of you. You're all extraordinary and amazing people that I was lucky to get to know. Try to always look for the silver lining. Sometimes right now that can be difficult, but if anybody can do it, I know that you all can. As you head out onto your next adventure, I want to give you all a virtual hug. I can't give you a real hug. And I want you to know that I and all of us at Mount Greylock wish you the best. We will certainly never forget your extraordinary class under these circumstances. You'll always, always have a special place in all of our hearts and all of our minds in this unprecedented situation. We love you, and please find the happiness and success you all deserve, and congratulations, class of 2020.
No, you can't. Air hug, air hug.
Members of the Mount Greylock class of 2020, it is an honor to address you today and to mark a very important event in your lives. While the circumstances of COVID-19 keep us apart and have rearranged the traditions of Mount Greylock's graduation exercises, I am thrilled to congratulate you on the accomplishments that brought you to this moment. Those accomplishments are many, whether in the classroom or out of the classroom, in internships, on work sites, in labs, in studios, on stages, on courses, trails, fields, and courts, and most recently, extensively on screens. The diversity of interests you pursue collectively and independently has not only given shape to your days, but also to your legacy. You've accepted challenges and worked hard towards meeting them. You are prepared, and we are ready to send you off to the wider world. What does that wider world look like? Not much like we thought it would look 6 months ago. And what is your role in this newly configured world? Excellent question. 2 months ago, when the ramifications of the pandemic were beginning to take form, Indian writer and political activist Arundhati Roy published a powerful challenge in the Financial Times. She wrote, "Whatever it is, coronavirus has made the mighty kneel and brought the world to a halt like nothing else could. Our minds are still racing back and forth, longing for a return to normality, stitching our future to our past and refusing to acknowledge the rupture. But the rupture exists, and in the midst of this terrible despair, it offers us a chance to rethink the doomsday machine we have built for ourselves. Nothing could be worse than a return to normality. Historically, pandemics have forced humans to break with the past and imagine their worlds anew. This one is no different. It's a portal, a gateway between one world and the next. We can choose to walk through it, dragging the carcasses of our prejudice and hatred, our avarice, our data banks and dead ideas, our dead rivers and smoky skies behind us. Or we can walk through lightly, with little luggage, ready to imagine another world and ready to fight for it. You, my dear seniors, have the capacity and the talent to imagine a new world, near and far. With passion and eloquence, you've conveyed frustration with injustice, inequality, insensitivity, and inaction regarding local, national, and global issues to your cohort and to the adults in your lives. I have certainly heard many well-developed arguments and ideas from you over your years at Mount Greylock. You have voices that are strong and clear. You have vision. You are, after all, the class of 2020. I've been waiting to tell you that as you leave Mount Greylock through a doorway that will bring you to the next destination, take those ideas, take that vision, and be responsible for it. Dietrich Bonhoeffer, a Lutheran minister who died at the hands of the Nazis, wrote, "Action springs not from thought, but from a readiness for responsibility." Gather your courage, fortify yourself, build alliances, and take responsibility to make your world, our world, a more just, equal, kind, and livable place. We need your energy and your ideas. I trust all 84 of you have much to contribute to the betterment of our world. As I close, I want to recognize your families for sending you to Mount Greylock to learn and grow, and for supporting the school through the many challenges, minor and major, that we've all faced. The other adults in your lives, your teachers and paraprofessionals, administrators and staff, will be eagerly waiting to celebrate and honor you after you receive your diplomas as you parade home. I personally want to thank your class officers, Alex, Anna, Gabby, and Mitchell, who have shouldered so much over the past 2 months and have rallied to represent you and work hard with your advisor, Lynn Jordan, to have a vibrant close to the last strange few months. Finally, members of the graduating class of 2020, I am extraordinarily proud of you, and I'm grateful to have spent these past school years with you. As I place my trust in you to shape a better, brighter world, I know it is not mislaid. Be safe, be well, and know how very deeply we care for you.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. but you never forget all the ones who love you and the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take, but more than anything. Yeah, more than anything. My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. Yeah. My wish for you is that this life becomes